Well, Mark, some great news for the Dundee Stars fans to hear that you've penned a new deal and a two-year extension to your contract.
Yeah, it's exciting. I mean, it's been a bit of a process with the Wards. We started talking a little bit before Christmas, and obviously with all the games that we played and that run-in with Christmas and New Year, we haven't had a chance to cross the T's and dot the I's, but we finally got it done and had a couple of days to go over everything, and I'm more than pleased.
I mean, how hard of a decision was it for you to commit your future to the Stars?
Not at all. I mean, I probably had to sleep over on one night, and that's it. And, you know, they showed a lot of faith in me in the summer, and it gave me an opportunity when a lot of people wouldn't have. And, you know, it's been a great working environment to work with them. And, you know, the big thing here is they let me coach. And it's not all doom and gloom when we lose a game. It's about how we get better as a team and how we get better as a club. And it's been a pleasant working environment.
Yeah, you mentioned that relationship you have with the owners. Of course, seems very close and very approachable. You must that must be an advantage to any coach if you're able to have that relationship with the ownership.
Yeah, it's easy. It's been, you know, it's a very open door policy that we have, and you know, we put a lot of trust in each other, and they put a lot of trust in me to you know, get this team where it needs to be. And you know, they've repaid me now with giving me an extension, and now I got to repay the favor by putting a quality team on the ice, and that's competing for trophies.
Yeah, of course. And since you came in, the fans and the players have done tremendous for you, more importantly. But what was your relationship with the fans like? Was that, did that play a part in your re-signing of the contract?
Not really, but it is a great fan base here. We got a lot of good hardcore fans here, and obviously we like to have more people in the building, but the ones that are here have been very supportive. Obviously, you get the odd negative comment here and there, but that's, you know, it bothers me. It's part of the business, and you got to expect that. But it's been a great relationship with everybody, the social club with Mark Jackson and Gail Markley from the social committee as well. So it's been really positive.
And before you came in, if you were to assess where you are now, as a team and as a coaching setup, are you happy with that? If you met your ambitions, overachieved?
Well, I wouldn't say overachieved, because you know, our goal was to compete for the conference, and you know, we're right there with Fife and Brayhead in a dogfight right now. And obviously, we're probably a little bit further up in the standings. I think most people would give us where we were going to be in the summer, but you know, we've got a lot of goals for ourselves. Obviously, we're not there yet, but you know, it's a process, and this two-year extension, it's part of the process and to where we want to be as a club and as a team. And you know, it's just one day at a time, one game at a time. We'll get there where we want to be, but you know, in game 52 we'll be looking to improve on things as well as we are in game one. So it's just the same. You're always looking to improve, and you know, from a personal standpoint, for myself, got to improve and mature as a coach as well. So I'm trying to get better myself every day, so it goes hand in hand. And but you know, with the players that we have here this year, they've committed to what we have. The owners have bought into where I see the club and my vision for the team, and it's been a pleasant experience so far.
And of course, maybe in previous years, the fans have seen players who obviously have done really well here but leave right after a season, and that must be difficult as a coach to continue on if you've not got any of the previous roster you wanted to keep here. Are you going to try and make plans to try and secure some of the players for the long-term future that are here already?
Well, I think we have a good core we can build around. Players that want to be in Dundee and want to be Stars, I think they've seen the setup now, and you know, they really enjoy it here. And obviously, we want to build around that. Obviously, with budgets and different things and you know, our other variables, you can't keep everybody. So, but we're going to try and attain at least a good core of guys so we can build around in the summer. But you know, we can't look ahead into the future too far, because you know, we got big games this weekend, big conference games, and obviously our goal is to win this conference title. And like I said the other night, you know, why not win the league if we can get on a good run here? So, you know, it's a process. It's one day at a time, one game at a time, like I said. And but obviously, we want to keep a good core.
Well, Mark, congratulations on the new deal, and we'll see you here for the future. Thank you.
Perfect. Thanks very much.